say you do a land search, you find there's a caveat. So let's say, Shamila, you let's say there's a caveat in the land search. Then what next? What shall I do? I mean, I saw a caveat. So what do I do now?
Okay, if you see a caveat in a land search, first you have to see what type of caveat is that. Let's say it's a private caveat person diriana. Then you do a further search, which is called caveat search. In that caveat search, actually, you can view the application which is used to lodge the caveat. In that application, what are the grounds for the caveat and who has entered the caveat? All that will be stated. With that, with the help of a lawyer, you can actually see whether it's a valid caveat or not.
Okay.
For an example.
Yeah, please.
No, I've come across a situation. A client bought a property through auction. Subsequent to that, they found out that there is a caveat on the property. And the caveat search shows the caveat is entered by an individual for a debt owed by the owner of the property to that person. That means the defaulting owner, the owner who did not pay the bank loan, has actually owed some money to an individual person privately. So that person has actually entered a caveat on the property. So upon discovery of these reasons, we filed an application to remove the caveat on the basis that the person who is the lender, who is the private lender, does not have caveatable interest on the property, because that person has no interest on the property. The interest is only on the amount of money given to the defaulting owner. Okay, so actually in that case, the bidder was very lucky. We got the caveat removed, and upon that only we managed to transfer the ownership.
So that means any caveat entered on the basis of he owe me money, that is it, I put a caveat, does not stand a chance to be a very strong caveat. Can you see
yes.
that?
Yes. Because for caveat, your right has to be on the property. You're claiming a right on the property, or you're claiming a registrable right on the property. Your right has to be capable to be registered on the title of the property. Then
so that means
the owing
or any money paid must be based on that particular property and not personally.